Hey there, folks. Bill O'Leary. And in this video, what I'm going to talk about is what happens to your online accounts after you die. So in this video, I'm going to talk about three things. One, what can happen to your online accounts after you die, number one. Number two, you're going to learn about the problems that occur when access to your online accounts, accessed by your executor or family, is delayed. And number three, the solution to the lack of access problem. So let me quickly tell you who I am. I'm Bill O'Leary. I'm an attorney here in Jacksonville, Florida. And my law firm is Legacy Planning Law Group. We focus on three things. Number one, estate planning, estates and trusts and wills, powers of attorney and the like. Number two, elder law. And number three, probate and estate and trust administration. So let's jump right in. I'm fascinated by this topic. Did you ever think what would happen to your online accounts when you die? Things like your online banking and brokerage accounts, maybe accounts that you've set up online with your insurance company, your annuity company, maybe your retirement plan like your 401k, your IRA. How about your online accounts that are not necessarily financial? Maybe like your Amazon account, your eBay, PayPal, maybe your Netflix account. What about the photos you store in the cloud? Online platforms like Shutterfly, Dropbox, Google Drive. How many of you still have, you know, paper photographs in the attic? Oh, and don't forget those email accounts that you have to log into, maybe travel awards accounts and the ever-present social media accounts like Facebook. These accounts are often referred to as digital assets. So do you have a plan for who will be able to access your digital assets after you die? Don't assume your executor or family members will have automatic access, because they won't, not unless you've given them specific consent. And by the way, sharing your passwords is not the specific consent that the law requires. In fact, sharing passwords is against the law. It violates not only the terms of service that a custodian or online platform uses, that's the sort of the long legalese that you have to read. Actually, nobody does read. You scroll to the bottom and you click accept. And that's what governs the account. But in addition to violating that terms of service agreement, it also violates two federal laws. So beyond the fact that it's illegal, don't think creating a password list and giving it to your family will work. Technology, folks, is quickly outpacing the password. If someone like your executor tries to use your password after you die to access one of your online accounts, and the executor uses a different computer than the one that you normally used or a different device, the technology gods will know this, and they likely will shut your executor out. This is called IP address authentication. Then, of course, there are the security questions that you answered or the two-factor authentication that you sent up when you created the account. Your executor probably is not going to know the answers to your security questions or what two-factor authentication you set up, and the executor is not going to be able to get past that step. And increasingly, sort of a voice or biometric recognition is going to be used instead of the passwords. That's what the experts say. Many predict that passwords eventually will no longer be used. So how do you go about providing this specific consent under the law? A good first step is to make sure that your will includes important legal verbiage granting access to your executor, access to your online accounts after you die. And in a similar fashion, if you become incapacitated, you should make sure that someone is specifically authorized to access your online accounts, again, while you're still living but incapacitated. And having a good power of attorney with this additional sort of access language is important. And by the way, we here at Legacy Planning Law Group, we have very good, very robust sort of specific consent verbiage we include in our wills, our trusts, and our powers of attorney. So let's back to the situation after you die. While having important legal verbiage is good, and important, more really should be done. You don't want your executor being delayed in trying to access your online accounts after you die because he or she is stuck in the probate court. And while, yes, your will can give them that necessary legal authority and consent with this additional verbiage, there's going to be an inevitable delay through the probate process. Imagine what might happen during that delay. Actions need to be taken, maybe initiating transfers on financial accounts. But your executor can't take that action, make those transfers, because the court has not approved them yet and done some other things that probate requires. And delays, by the way, beyond your executor not being able to act quickly, guess what else a delay will do? It invites fraud and theft. Look, the bad guys know. They have ways of detecting periods of inactivity on accounts. And what do? They jump in and commit fraud. They somehow access your accounts. So what's the solution? Having an online tool. This is a platform you can set up now while you're alive, where you set in place directions for each of your accounts, your digital assets, right? So you decide what's going to happen to each of your accounts when you die. Who do you want to give access to? Your executor, other family members? Is this going to be unlimited access, maybe restricted or limited access? Maybe you don't want to give anybody access to your account at all. Maybe privacy is more important than access. Maybe you want that account closed immediately at your death. So an online tool is where you can set in place directives now that are implemented automatically when you die. In fact, we here at Legacy Planning Law Group, we offer an online tool to those of our clients who enroll in our client care program. We've partnered with a secure third-party provider. And the neat thing about the platform that we use, that we partner with, I should say, is they don't need your password, don't even want your passwords in order for this to be set up and set up right. Your passwords are not needed in order for your account to be set up and for you to be able to set in place your directives for all of your online digital accounts. We'd love to tell you more about the online tool that we make available to our clients. So if you'd like to know more about what happens to your online accounts after you die, and maybe how we can help, or maybe want to know a little bit more about this online tool that we offer our clients, we'd love to talk to you. So we encourage you to go ahead and schedule a free 15-minute discovery phone call. It's free and it's easy. Just go to our booking calendar by clicking on the registration link at the bottom of this video, or you can go to our website, legacyplanninglawgroup.com, and there are buttons all over the place. It's a blue button that says book your free call. Click on that. Both will take you straight to the same place, our booking calendar. Just pick a day and time that works best for you. So this is Bill O'Leary and signing off for now. On behalf of everybody here at Team Legacy, go make it a great day and a better world.